So good evening, everyone, and welcome to this webinar on the pathway to the Indian women's cricket team. So my name is Nikhil Jha. I am part of the Nurture cricket team. And I'll just give you a quick brief and quick intro about who we are, what we are doing, and then introduce our very special guest and continue with the webinar. Right. So as some of you might be aware, if you went to our website, Nurture has a vision to fulfill 7 billion dreams. So anyone who wants to achieve something, we plan to have that learning imbibed on our platform. So we started with chess about 3 years ago, and we are already present in, there are learners across 90 countries, and there are international masters and grandmasters spread all across the world, right from US, Eastern Europe to India, and more than 10,000-15,000 people have learned chess through our platform. Now, last year, as a continuing effort to add more more verticals and get more people to learn other stuff, we collaborated with the legendary coach Gary Kirsten, who some of you or all of you might remember as the World Cup winning coach for the Indian cricket team. And he came up with this comprehensive online course on cricket, which is in the beta launch phase on our website. And as a continuing effort to have more mentors and share more learning about cricket, we are doing events like this one. One of the regular things that we keep receiving is and it's quite heartening to see, we receive a lot of questions from aspiring, budding female cricketers like all of you who are present here. And as a part of sharing information and sharing learnings, we thought we would invite someone who has been there, done that, and is also involved in the ecosystem even after playing. And we could think of no one better than our guest tonight, Snehal. Now, Snehal is an ex-Indian cricketer, and currently she is also involved in broadcasting, writing about cricket, and she's involved with this project called the Equal Hue Project, and they have come up with one of the best reports that I've read in on grassroots cricket, specifically focused on women's cricket in India. So welcome, Snehal. Thanks for taking out the time and sharing your knowledge and inspiring this bunch of aspiring female cricketers that are assembled here.
Yeah, happy to be here, Nikhil. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, great. So for everyone's benefit, I'll just reiterate what we will do in this session. So we have a few questions that we had planned with Snehal earlier, and a lot of you all have also sent in your questions. So what we will do is we'll just spend about 10-15 minutes recounting, revisiting Snehal's journey to the women's cricket team. And I think there is a lot of things you would be, find in common, and you would also feel that we are also on a similar path. We also face the same problem, overcome and get there. So we'll do that for the first about 10-15 minutes. Then for the next half an hour, we'll take up questions that we have already received. It was great to see some very interesting questions that have come in. And all of you, during the course of the session, whenever you want, just put in questions in chat. One of our teammates here will collate those questions and keep on prompting us to answer those. So even if you have not been able to send in your questions earlier, don't worry about that. Just in the chat box, just keep on putting in your questions, and we'll select, depending on the time that we have, we'll select the ones to answer. Cool. So let us begin with the Q&A part first. Snehal, the first and most obvious question, if you look back at your journey to become a female cricketer, which is really a tough part to take, especially, probably a decade ago, how did you get into cricket? When did you decide to become a cricketer? And, you know, can you share something from your early days?
I was always into sports. As a kid, I played pretty much every sport. I think cricket was a little bit more special to me because my parents, even before I have any memories, they remember telling me, they tell me that they remember me picking up anything I can in my hand and swinging it around like a bat. Then I, while playing all sports, I got introduced to cricket because luckily my grandmother knew Shubhangi Kulkarni, who was the former captain of the Indian women's team. She's also from Pune. Mm-hmm. And through meeting her, I got an idea of where the Maharashtra team trains, and I started joining training with them. Mm-hmm. And there it became a little formal, and then I started focusing only on cricket. And I really saw that dream of playing cricket for India when I saw Jhulan Goswami's debut. And just watching her bowl, that time she was 19 years old, the first time a series was coming on TV, and so fast, and just being such a problem for the opposition team's batsmen or the batters, mm-hmm. that I got this inspiration that I want to open the bowling for India with Jhulan Goswami. I want to be her bowling partner. Like, and that was the first, that was the concrete dream of playing for India. So it's so important to be able to see those people. Like, if that series had not been on TV, I would not have that concrete dream. And because it was on TV, because I could see her and I got that inspiration, I had that very clear dream that this is what I want to do with my cricket.
Right. So it's important to have those role models who inspire you, and you know, you aspire to become that. That's a great point. So when did you decide, or when did you realize that, hey, this looks like it's not just a dream. I can actually go ahead and play for India.
So I was playing cricket regularly. I was doing well. I was playing for Maharashtra team. I was doing well for the Maharashtra team during my student days, playing for West Zone, getting selected, moving forward in the journey. But I was also side by side studying. I come from a very open-minded family where they support cricket a lot, but it's also a family where studies is given a lot of importance because for example, my grandfather and grandmother did research into marine biology in the 1950s. Grandfather has a PhD. My grandmother has a MSc. Mm-hmm. My father is an engineer. So we are in a family where it's quite, that academics is also quite important. So side by side with studying my BSc, I was trying to decide whether I can continue cricket after BSc. Because after BSc, I would have had to either look for MBA or MSc, or I had these options open in front of me. I knew I was smart enough. I knew I could get the marks and clear the exams. So whether at that stage I can continue playing cricket and maybe even play for India, I did not know, because at that point I was earning nothing playing cricket. So wo soch thi man mein ki kitne dino tak, you know, mummy papa se cricket se paise le leke khelte rahu. आगे अपने करियर के बारे में भी कुछ सोचना पड़ेगा. सो उस स्टेज पे लकीली आई गॉट सिलेक्टेड इन वेस्टर्न रेलवे इन अ स्पोर्ट्स कोटा जॉब. सो बिकॉज क्रिकेट हैड दैट स्पोर्ट्स कोटा एम्प्लॉयमेंट, आई कुड कंटिन्यू प्लेइंग क्रिकेट इन अ सेमी प्रोफेशनल मैनर. एंड दैट वाज 2007. एंड इन वन ईयर्स टाइम इन 2008 आई प्लेड फॉर इंडिया.
Awesome. So in terms of one follow-up question that I had, in terms of that, and probably we'll revisit that question because some of the attendees also had that question. In terms of the grassroots structure that you have, so you have recounted that you were part of the Maharashtra team, and even before that, you were playing cricket at a serious level. So what are the kind of, were you in a place where there was a structured pathway, or there were some grassroots structures that were already there, or did you have to shift from one place to the other to be able to take advantage of those structures?
I did not have to shift. What I did have to do was sacrifice a lot in my life to be able to participate in those structures. Mm-hmm. So to give you an idea of what it was, this is 2005 ki baat. Mm-hmm. I finished my graduation in 2005. Mm-hmm. I finished my 12th in 2004. Mm-hmm. So around that time, it was pre-BCCI. That time BCCI did not run women's cricket. That time it was run by Women's Cricket Association of India up till 2006. Mm-hmm. So that time we had under 16. Mm-hmm. We would play under 16s, under 19s, and then senior. So this was the pathway. Mm-hmm. And by that time I had already finished playing under 19s. I was in the senior pathway. So you play for your district, you can play for your state, then you can play for your zone also. From you play interzonals, west zone versus east zone versus north zone, etc. Mm-hmm. And then from there, the pathway was to play for India. Mm-hmm. One thing we also got advantage was at that time, the Women's Cricket Association of India was very proactive. So they selected an India under 21 team mm-hmm. to go to Pakistan. Mm-hmm. So even before playing for India, we got that international exposure and we went to Pakistan. Mm-hmm. Now the pathway is very different. Mm-hmm. Under BCCI, and we'll probably talk about that later. Yeah. Yeah. But I had to, I was in a good place because Pune was we had a lot of girls playing cricket, so we had that support, and I had the family support also. I had to sacrifice in terms of how to manage this side by side with my studies mm-hmm. because doing BSc, it's not just that aap college hi mat jao mm-hmm. aur bas attendance mark kar lo aur bas ant mein exam de do, aapko practicals dene hai, internal exams dene hai, all those kind of things were also challenge, and balancing those kind of things was a pretty tough time at that time. Yeah. But I had good support from college also, and that's why I could get through it.
Okay, great. And was there did the college and the school that you attended, they also had teams, or was it like a few colleges or schools coming together and forming a team? How did that happen?
So when I was in school, that is, I did my 10th standard in 2002, mm-hmm. There were no girls cricket teams. So I used to play with the boys, just to practice with the boys. But when they played their matches, their inter-school matches, I couldn't play. Mm-hmm. So there was no matches for me in school. There was no college team in my college either. Mm-hmm. So 1 year we formed a team and we tried to play. But next year it was difficult to find so many girls to find a team. Mm-hmm. What we did have was we had good inter-university cricket structure. So even right now, women's cricket does have a good inter-university cricket structure where even if, for example, mere college mein team nahi thi, par main trials de sakti hu, Pune University mein sare jo bhi colleges hai, wahan se jo ladkiyan register kiye hue hai, unki trials hote the, and they used to pick up Pune University team. And then Pune University versus Mumbai University versus Annamalai University versus Guru Nanak University. Mm-hmm. was a very, very competitive inter-university tournament because all the state players played in that tournament.
Right. Okay. So this is similar to the Rohinton Barrier Cup that happens for men's. This is the exact analogy for that in
women's. Yes.
Oh, awesome. So in terms of so one of the things that I'm hearing is that in terms of the initiative that you need to take, it's not as obvious, and probably again things might be changing, but it's not as obvious, and you have to take the first few steps yourself in terms of proactiveness. Ki pata karo where are the trials happening, what is the structure in terms of inter-university. There is no one central place where you get all of that information. You'll need to figure stuff out yourself.
That is one very big gap even in the system today. Mm-hmm. कि लड़कियों को especially पता ही नहीं है कि हम state के लिए कैसे खेल सकते हैं या हम हमारे university के लिए कैसे खेल सकते हैं. Mm-hmm. And this awareness needs to be there. Mm-hmm. I see a lot of girls seeing what the Indian team did in 2017 or even reaching the final in 2020. वो देख के वो academy जाते हैं पर वहाँ से आगे वो district team तक state team तक कैसे पहुँचे. ये पता नहीं है, एंड इट्स अप टू इंडिविजुअल स्टेट एसोसिएशंस टू रियली मेक दैट पब्लिक एंड मेक इट वेल नोन. क्योंकि लड़कों में पता है कि इस एकेडमी से खेलो तो आपको ये मैचेस खिलाएंगे, ये टूर्नामेंट खिलाएंगे, फिर यहाँ से आप डिस्ट्रिक्ट खेलोगे, यहाँ से डिस्ट्रिक्ट में परफॉर्म किया तो स्टेट खेलोगे. ये सिस्टम पता है लड़कों में, पर लड़कियों में वो सिस्टम क्या है, इट्स नॉट वेरी क्लियर.
Right. All right. So the projects and the research projects that you are involved with, they are they are a step in that direction. Ki there should be someone talking about it, someone highlighting these issue, making this repository or this core platform where at least information is there. And that's I agree, and I really appreciate having seen the report what you are contributing to. So getting back to your journey now, we already discussed about one of the barriers that you had to sort of overcome, which is that this lack of information, and probably fill that in with your own proactiveness, and probably as you said, that try and form a team and figure out where are the trials and all of that. So one part is the lack lack of information which you filled in with your proactiveness. What were some of, you know, if you have to look back, probably a couple of other huge barriers that you had to cross to reach where you did reach?
There were a few instances where being a girl on the ground, being the only girl on the ground, was not normal, and it made some people uncomfortable. 95% of the time, I would train with boys, and 95% of the time, I would be the only girl on the ground, and it used to be fine. Coaches used to be supportive, the boys used to be welcoming. Generally, chote ladko ke saath training hoti hai to match the physical skill level in terms of pace and all. So I'm always like a didi for them. But there have been occasions when I started going to an academy, for instance, the coach would tell me to tie my hair up or put it in my hat and hide it. Because you don't need to show that there is a girl here on the ground and she is teaching a girl. There was one practice match I was playing with boys in Bombay, and they said that they wouldn't play with a girl in the Samne Wali team. And this was after even playing for India. So those kind of barriers are very much there. I think per the bigger barriers might be, and maybe people in the comments will tell us whether this is true, ki ghar se agar support nahi mila to aap ground pe hi pohch nahi sakte ho, kyunki mujhe ghar se acha khasa support mila, colleges se, school se support mila, to main ground pe pohch sakti thi and I could play for my state. Par I think mera hunch ye hai ki bahut sari ladkiyon ko wo ghar se support milta hi nahi hai, isliye wo ground pe aati hi nahi hai, kyunki 99% of the girls in cricket have good family support. Even if it's not financial support, wo encourage karte hain ki aap jao cricket khelo. Magar bahut kam aise ladkiyan milti hain jo kehte hain ki ghar walon se ladke aaye. So I think agar ghar wale mana karte hain, then the girls cannot just come to the ground at all.
Mm-hmm. Right. And you have rightly pointed this out. This has come up in our questions as well. The support from family. And it's such a difficult question. Do you think there is an answer to it? If there is no even, let's say, moral support from the family, is there a way to address that or answer that?
I think ek cheez dekhi hai, like for example, I'll give the example of Poonam Yadav. Most of the people here will know Poonam Yadav. She's a spinner, best leg spinner in the world, spinner with the Indian team. Agra ki ladki hai. Aur unke papa mana karte the ki aapko chot lagegi, aapke haathon pe aise dive wave maarne ke wajah se daag lagenge. To is karan aap cricket mat khelo. So the coaches intervened, the coaches went home. And they spoke to the parents, bataya ki aapki ladkiyon mein talent hai aur aap unhi khelne dijiye, aage acha hoga jo bhi hoga. So ye coaches ka jo intervention hai, wo I think women's ke case mein zyada important hai. Ladko mein I think parents or children, they go together to the ground and they talk to the coaches. But women's ke case mein coaches ko ghar pe jaake parents ke saath baat karna might be sometimes necessary.
Right. So you are saying some senior person, some role model or one should help in this intervention and try and convince. Fair point. Right. So again, going back to your journey. So just to summarize, we talked about three barriers. One, lack of information, which unfortunately we are still in the process of trying to solve for that. But one solution for that is to be really proactive and just figure stuff out and do something, probably create a team and then find out where are trials. Second part is the 95% boys thing that you talked about, but again, there is no easy solution for that. It's a more top level thing where as and when there will be more matches on TV, where more people, there will be more role models, there would be more people, more inspiring people on in the news, on TV, slowly that is going to change. And I hope that some of the academies also have mixed batches or separate batches now where they they train female cricketers. And the third one that we talked about was the, you know, that family support one, which, as you rightly pointed out, probably needs an external intervention. Now, going back to your journey, what did it feel like when you walked out for the first time in that, you know, Team India jersey and cap? So can you summarize that feeling for us, and probably one or two moments from your journey as an international cricketer?
The India cap wala feeling, I really remember not the time I played for the India senior team, but the time I played for the India under 21 team, because that was also the first time you're playing for a national level. And it is, I remember, because like I said, in Sunny Sports, where Shubhangi Kulkarni was the secretary of the Women's Cricket Association of India, she was guiding us, and they were manufacturing the kit for the India under 21 team. So hamare cap pe embroidered piche hamare naam the. So I could go to the shop, because I lived in Pune, I could go to the shop, aur kit sabko milne se pehle mujhe main apna India cap dekh sakti thi, aur uske piche jo naam likha tha mera, that was like an awesome feeling. Aur aage India ka logo, to think about wearing that was a very special feeling. Aur phir aage jaake, one of my best memories, happy memories, I think, playing for India is getting Meg Lanning out. Aur ab Meg Lanning ek bahut hi badi batting superstar ban gayi hai, par I can say that, you know, in the wickets that I took in international cricket, Meg Lanning is one of them. So that is one of the fond memories. At that time, I did not know, you know, ek kaun ladki hai, nahi ladki hai. She's a new batter in the Australian team, but now to see that she's become such a superstar batter, I can say I got Meg Lanning out.
Right. Awesome. So I think we will, you know, since probably you'll have to leave in 15-20 minutes, probably we'll just take up the questions. But before we do that, I just had one final question from our initial set. You are someone who is now involved after your playing days. You have been involved in the ecosystem, you know, sort of like a lighthouse for the future generation, both in terms of research, in terms of the YouTube channel that you run. So what are some of the trends that you're observing? What are some of the things that are changing, and what are some of the things that, you know, probably are the same, and people need to, you know, sort of figure stuff out and try and force that change to happen?
One trend I'm observing is that fathers who played cricket in their youth are now looking even at their daughters as, you know, ye ladki bhi aage jaake cricket khel sakti hai, sometimes more than their sons. हमेशा ये देखा जाता है, मतलब वो दंगल वाली स्टोरी लाइन है कि अगर पापा इंडिया के लिए नहीं खेल पाया या क्रिकेट के सपने नहीं पूरे कर पाया तो ही थिंक्स दैट द सन विल डू इट. बट नाउ द ट्रेंड आई एम सीइंग इज दैट दे थिंक ऑल्सो दैट द डॉटर विल डू इट. शफाली वर्मा इज अ परफेक्ट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दैट, कि उसका भाई भी क्रिकेट खेलता है, मगर जो छोटी बहन है, उस भाई की छोटी बहन है, शी इज द वन हुज गॉन ऑन टू प्ले फॉर इंडिया. स्मृति मंधना ऑल्सो वेरी सिमिलर, वेरी सिमिलर स्टोरी. और दूसरा एक ट्रेंड मैं देख रही हूँ कि मोर एंड मोर किड्स आर लर्निंग ऑनलाइन. सो जो टैलेंट है वो सिटी के बाहर है. सेम एग्जाम्पल, शफाली वर्मा रोहतक हरियाणा, स्मृति मंधना सांगली महाराष्ट्र, हरमनप्रीत कौर मोगा पंजाब. तो जो टैलेंट है वो सिटी के बाहर है, और जो एक्सपर्टीज है, जो कोचिंग है, फैसिलिटीज है, अच्छे कोचेस है, वो सिटीज में है. तो वो दूरी ब्रिज करने के लिए आई एम सीइंग दैट पीपल आर यूजिंग द ऑनलाइन मीडियम टू ब्रिज दैट. लाइक आई हैव एन ऑनलाइन कोचिंग प्रोग्राम व्हिच आई स्टार्टेड ड्यूरिंग लॉकडाउन, और वहां से आई हैव स्टूडेंट्स फ्रॉम महेंद्रगढ़ इन हरियाणा, आई हैव स्टूडेंट्स इन सम गांव इन यूपी जिसका नाम भी नहीं पता, सेम इन गुजरात, मैसूर, जस्ट आउटसाइड पुणे. जो लड़कियां अप डाउन कर नहीं सकती है, ट्रैवल नहीं कर सकती है, उनको गाइडेंस घर पे बैठे बैठे मिलता है, क्योंकि वी कैन टॉक थ्रू वीडियो कॉल. सो दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ ट्रेंड दैट आई एम सीइंग, दैट मोर एंड मोर कोचिंग, यू गाइस विल आल्सो बी सीइंग इट इन दिस फील्ड ऑफ ऑनलाइन कोचिंग, एंड दोस क्वेश्चंस आर नाउ बीइंग आंसर्ड वाया टेक्नोलॉजी. एंड ज्योग्राफी का इतना फर्क नहीं पड़ रहा है, वेयर एवर यू स्टे इन इंडिया और द वर्ल्ड, यू कैन रीच गुड कोचेस एंड गेट गुड गाइडेंस.
Right. Awesome. So that sort of aligns to what both of us are trying to do in terms of getting empowering more people to come up and pursue their dreams. We'll now Snehal, in the last probably 15-20 minutes till you are here, we'll just take up a few broad questions that there are in fact a lot of questions that have come in the chat box as well. So we'll just pick up the ones that we got earlier first, and then if we have time, we'll go through a few of them here. So one of the common themes that we saw in the questions that were submitted was about what is the right time. A lot of people said that they were 20, 22, 25. So one part was that what, when is it quote unquote too late, or when even if it is late, is it still a good time to have that dream to play for India? That was part one of the question. And part two was, let's say if somebody is 16, 18 years old, where traditionally there is still time, what is that time that they need to give themselves? What, 2 years, 3 years, and what is the pathway that you need to follow? So a two-part question, one about being too late, and second part about just on the cusp of being the right age, what is the path that one needs to follow?
So as far as 20 plus is concerned, आप बिल्कुल क्रिकेट खेल सकते हो. स्पेशली लड़कियों में कॉम्पिटिशन थोड़ा कम है तो आपके चांसेस जरा ज्यादा है. बट अंडरस्टैंड दैट द मोर योर एज इज द मोर डिफिकल्ट इट विल बी. तो ये एक्सपेक्टेशन अगर आप मन में रखोगे कि द मोर योर एज द ओल्डर यू आर द मोर डिफिकल्ट इट विल बी, वो क्लियर अंडरस्टैंडिंग आपके मन में रख के यू शुड स्टार्ट प्लेइंग क्रिकेट. सेकेंड एडवाइस इज स्टार्ट प्लेइंग क्रिकेट. If you are starting playing cricket at the age of 20 plus, आप cricket enjoy करने के लिए खेलो, rather than have that competitive attitude in mind. वो हुआ तो बहुत अच्छा है, आप आगे select हुए तो बहुत अच्छी बात है. But keep in mind that you want to play cricket because you enjoy playing cricket. So even if you are playing cricket at the club level, अगर आपको उन matches में मजा आ रहा है at the age of 22, you are fulfilling your dream. If you want to play at higher level, अगर आपको मजा आ रहा है तो आपका performance अच्छा होगा तो आप आगे जाने के chances ज्यादा है. Understand कि बहुत सारे success stories है. Natarajan, for example, at the age of 20, he started bowling with leather ball. बहुत सारे success stories है कि बाद में शुरू करके आप इंडिया के लिए खेले. मगर with those success stories, there are also a lot of failures. So, अगर आप 20 plus में शुरू कर रहे हो, have a backup plan. आपका backup plan क्या है? और वो बहुत clear रख के, फिर आप for the sake of enjoying cricket खेलो. जहाँ तक बात हुई 16 to 18 category, मैं हमेशा अपने students से कहती हूँ कि you have to give yourself 2 years time आपको आपके skills को mature होने के लिए. कोई भी मतलब batting हो या bowling हो, ये बहुत अजीबोगरीब movements है कि बिल्कुल आप हम चलते हैं नॉर्मल मूव्स सामने रख के, मगर बैटिंग आपको साइडवेज करना है, बॉलिंग आपको साइडवेज करना है, तो वो बहुत अजीबोगरीब मूवमेंट्स हैं. फॉर योर स्किल टू डेवलप इन दीज मूवमेंट्स टू गेट द इनटू द राइट पोजीशंस व्हाइल बैटिंग और बॉलिंग, यू नीड टू गिव योरसेल्फ 2 years टाइम. दैट टाइम पीरियड इज शॉर्टेंड इफ यू हैव गुड गाइडेंस. इफ यू हैव पीपल टेलिंग यू टू ट्रेन द राइट वे, दैट टाइम पीरियड इज शॉर्टेंड. क्योंकि अगर मतलब मैंने अपने करियर में ये देखा है कि हाफ द टाइम इज स्पेंट करेक्टिंग मिस्टेक्स दैट वी मेक बिफोर. सो आई वुड से स्टूडेंट्स हु आर 16-18, यू हैव टू गिव योरसेल्फ अ कपल ऑफ इयर्स, यस, बट आल्सो इन्वेस्ट टाइम एंड एफर्ट इनटू फाइंडिंग द राइट कोच फॉर यू हु कैन गिव दैट काइंड ऑफ गाइडेंस. बहुत लोग कोचिंग में बाद में इन्वेस्ट करते हैं कि देखते हैं टैलेंट है क्या, फिर उसके बाद इन्वेस्ट करेंगे. पर आई वुड सजेस्ट कि मेक दैट चॉइस अ लिटिल अर्लियर, ताकि आपको क्लियरली पता चले कि क्रिकेट में मतलब इंस्टेड ऑफ फाइंडिंग आउट इन 2 years, यू विल फाइंड आउट इन 1.5 years, और फिर 6 महीने आपके हाथ में है. एंड टाइम इज द मोस्ट प्रेशियस थिंग फॉर अ एज ग्रुप क्रिकेटर.
Right. That's probably one of those insights that only a cricketer can give. And thanks for that. I think a follow-up question to that is something that quite a few people are asking in chat and earlier also. Once you have, let's say you said that find the right coach and give yourself time. Is there a process to that? As in, a lot of people are asking, what is a good academy? How to find the right academy? Is there club cricket? How to find club cricket? So is there a right answer to that?
So in terms of academy, I will give you two pieces of advice. One is that find an academy which plays lots of matches. बिकॉज अगर आप ट्रायल्स खेल रहे हो, ट्रायल्स के लिए जा रहे हो, तो एनी वन कैन जस्ट से कि नहीं आज तुमने बैटिंग अच्छी नहीं की, तुम्हारे टेक्निक अच्छा नहीं है, मैं तुम्हें सिलेक्ट नहीं करूंगा. पर मैचेस में जाके अगर आप परफॉर्म करोगे तो आगे के सिलेक्शन के लिए बेटर है, क्योंकि आपके स्कोर बुक पे नाम के सामने स्कोर है. अगर आपने 50 रन किए, 100 रन किए, तो आपको कोई अनसिलेक्ट नहीं कर सकता है. सो फाइंड एन अकेडमी विच विल प्ले अ लॉट ऑफ मैचेस. सेकेंड थिंग इज कि अंडरस्टैंड कि अकेडमी में आपको नेट्स में सिर्फ 10 मिनट बैटिंग मिलने वाली है, वो भी प्रोबेबली 2 or 3 टाइम्स अ वीक, क्योंकि बच्चे होते हैं 20 से 30 एक बैच में और कोच होता है एक. तो अगर आप अकेडमी पे डिपेंडेंट रहोगे आपके क्रिकेट के लिए, तो इट विल नॉट बी इनफ. आपको खुद को एजुकेट करना है. इंटरनेट का जमाना है, हियर वी आर रीचिंग पीपल थ्रू क्रिकेट. गो ऑन यूट्यूब, लिसन टू क्रिकेटर्स, वॉच वीडियोस अबाउट टेक्निक, लर्न एज मच एज यू कैन आउटसाइड द अकेडमी. तब जाके आपकी अकेडमी में परफॉर्मेंस अच्छी रहेगी. आप नेट्स में अच्छे से बैटिंग करोगे बिकॉज यू आर लर्निंग आउटसाइड. इफ यू आर बैटिंग वेल इन द नेट्स, कोच विल थिंक हाँ चलो मैच जब आएगा तब इसको एक ज्यादा चांसेस मिले, ऊपर बैटिंग दे दे या बॉलिंग के बारे में न्यू बॉल दे उसको या फर्स्ट चेन स्पिनर बनाए. सो अकेडमी मतलब जैसे हम स्कूल जाते हैं पर स्कूल के बाहर भी बहुत कुछ सीखते हैं, वैसे अकेडमी जाके क्रिकेट सीखोगे, पर अकेडमी पर ज्यादा आप सीखोगे इंटरनेट से अकेडमी के बाहर. सो दैट इज द राइट अप्रोच फॉर एन अकेडमी. थर्डली थोड़ा सीनियर क्रिकेटर्स के साथ बातें करो टू फाइंड आउट हु आर द गुड कोचेस इन योर एरिया, और वहां पे आप ट्राई करो कि शुरू करें.
Right. So, what I am hearing is that there is no, as in, there is no like, you will not no find formula. A dedicated this thing ki just dial pe gaye and just search mara women's academy to wo nahi mila.
90% log kya karte hain, jo ghar ke paas wali academy hai wahan pe jate hain. Par usse pehle aap agar local cricketers ke saath baat kar sakte ho, find out a little bit more about the academy. Knowledge pura cricket circle mein hai, aapko just dial pe ya internet pe milne ke chances kam hai. So try and speak to cricketers as much as possible. To find out which is a good academy at that time.
Right, excellent advice. I think one of the things that probably we need to do, we'll have to crowdsource this knowledge and put it online. One of the I think this was there in the report that you had shared as well. Right. So let us assume that someone has found the right academy and they play quite a few matches. And Snehal, when you're talking about these matches, are these exclusively girls matches, or as you recounted your own journey that there are mixed matches as well? So there isn't really again a very simple answer to that.
90% of the time academies don't have girls teams. So you have to be mentally prepared कि आप अकेले लड़के, आप अकेले अकेली लड़की लड़कों की टीम में आपको खेलना पड़ेगा. So that is something which you have to be prepared for.
Right. All right. So let us assume that this part is sorted and folks have found a local place where they can practice and play matches. What happens next? As in, what is the more more structured pathway to get to the Indian team? And I think a lot of people have asked it here as well, and in our previous questions also. What is the next step from these local academies and matches to the Indian team?
So best advice, ek fit formula nahin hai. Alag-alag states have different setups. For example, Mumbai mein they have an under-16 setup also, despite India mein under-16 tournament khela nahin jata hai. So first मैं वो बताती हूँ कि इंडिया में BCCI के अंडर 23, अंडर 19 और सीनियर, ये तीन एज ग्रुप्स में क्रिकेट खेला जाता है लड़कियों में. बट स्टिल सम प्लेसेस लाइक मुंबई हैव अंडर 16 क्रिकेट आल्सो फॉर गर्ल्स. सम प्लेसेस लाइक महाराष्ट्र डोंट हैव दैट. बंगाल में अलग सिचुएशन है, दिल्ली में अलग सिचुएशन है. बेस्ट एडवाइस आई कैन गिव यू इज गो ऑन द इंटरनेट और आपके स्टेट एसोसिएशन का नंबर निकालो. स्टेट एसोसिएशन का नंबर निकाल के उनको फोन करो और पूछो कि आपके एरिया में आपके स्टेट के लिए क्या सिचुएशन है. कि मैं अगर रहती हूँ सोलापुर में, तो सोलापुर में अगर मुझे महाराष्ट्र क्रिकेट टीम के लिए खेलना है तो मुझे क्या करना पड़ेगा, और फाइंड आउट सम इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम देम. दूसरी चीज, अगर आप ऑलरेडी अकेडमी जा रहे हो तो आपके अगर सीनियर क्रिकेटर्स हैं, सीनियर वुमेन्स क्रिकेटर्स अगर वहां पे हैं, तो वो आपको गाइड करेंगे, पर डोंट डिपेंड ऑन देम. आप खुद भी आपका इन्वेस्टिगेशन चालू रखो, आप खुद भी फाइंड आउट करो कि ये करंट पाथवे क्या है, आपकी स्टेट के हिसाब से कब होने वाला है. इस चीज के लिए आपको यू विल नीड टू मेक बी रेडी टू मेक 10 फोन कॉल्स एंड ओनली वंस यू विल गेट इन्फॉर्मेशन. तो वो प्रोएक्टिव एटीट्यूड जो आपने कहा दैट यू विल डेफिनेटली हैव टू कीप because it is difficult to get this information, but this is the way to get that information by speaking to senior cricketers and by picking up the phone, calling the state association and asking what the pathway is in your particular area. The traditional pathway is ki aap academy ke liye khelloge to academy ke beech mein club matches honge, wahan se aap district ke liye khelloge, district, state aur fir zone ke liye. Magar most academies don't have women's teams. Yahan pe baat thodi fasti hai. स्कूल क्रिकेट होता नहीं है, जो हमने हमारे रिपोर्ट में हाईलाइट किया है कि इंटर स्कूल गर्ल्स क्रिकेट रेगुलरली होता नहीं है, तो आगे कैसे बढ़े लड़कियां. तो 10 अकेडमियां हैं, हर अकेडमी में एक एक लड़की है, उन 10 लड़कियों को हम इकट्ठा कैसे लाएं इज द बिगेस्ट क्वेश्चन. द आंसर इज डिफरेंट फॉर एवरी स्टेट एसोसिएशन. सो द बेस्ट वे टू स्टार्ट दिस आंसर इज टू फाइंड आउट इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम द स्टेट एसोसिएशन.
Okay, and let's say since you would have more experience in your own state, if you have to recount your journey, your state, and I'm guessing seeing the questions, a few of them are from that Mumbai Pune region. So can you let us know what is the pathway for let's say the Mumbai Pune or Maharashtra region to get into the Indian team?
So, अगर आप मुंबई में हो, मुंबई हैज अ नंबर ऑफ क्लब टूर्नामेंट्स लड़कियों के लिए. मुंबई का आई थिंक 2018-19 तक इंटर स्कूल लड़कियों की टूर्नामेंट भी थी. सो आस्क योर स्कूल टू कॉन्टेक्ट मुंबई क्रिकेट एसोसिएशन टू फाइंड आउट कैन यू प्ले इन देयर इंटर स्कूल टूर्नामेंट. आस्क योर अकेडमी कोच टू कॉल अप मुंबई क्रिकेट एसोसिएशन टू फाइंड आउट कि उनके ट्रायल्स कब होते हैं और आप वहाँ पे कब जा सकते हो. यूजुअली समर कैंप्स उनके लगते हैं मुंबई क्रिकेट एसोसिएशन के, वहां पे आप ज्वाइन कर सकते हो और समर कैंप में जो टैलेंटेड लड़कियां हैं उनको पिकअप करके मुंबई क्रिकेट एसोसिएशन के प्रोग्राम्स में इंडक्ट किया जाता है. सो फाइंड आउट समर कैंप्स कब होते हैं मुंबई क्रिकेट एसोसिएशन के. पुणे की बात करें तो यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट विच अकेडमीज हैव वुमेन्स क्रिकेट, कौन से अकेडमीज में लड़कियां हैं. देर आर फ्यू अकेडमीज, पुराने अकेडमीज जैसे डेक्कन जिमखाना, PYC, फ्यू न्यूअर प्लेसेस लाइक HK बाउंस अकेडमी, यहाँ पे लड़कियों के टीम्स हैं और कभी कभी उनके बीच में क्लब टूर्नामेंट्स होते रहते हैं. मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंटली यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट सीनियर प्लेयर्स कौन है आपके एरिया में. सो पुणे में जो सीनियर प्लेयर्स हैं उनके टच में रहो, दो हफ्ते में एक बार उनको कॉल करो, पूछो कि कहाँ पे टूर्नामेंट हो रही है. एंड कुछ प्राइवेट टूर्नामेंट्स भी होती है. फॉर एग्जांपल पुणे में एक प्राइवेट इनविटेशन टूर्नामेंट हो रही है फिलहाल विच आई एम प्लेइंग इन. सो देर आर सीनियर क्रिकेटर्स देर हु विल बी एबल टू गिव यू दैट इन्फॉर्मेशन. जस्ट बी इन टच विद देम, फाइंड आउट वेयर दे प्रैक्टिस. थोड़ा आपको शर्लॉक होम्स बनना पड़ेगा यहाँ पे. अगर आप डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स में हो, पुणे के बाहर हो, तो आपके डिस्ट्रिक्ट एसोसिएशन को कॉल करो या आपके डिस्ट्रिक्ट में हमेशा हर डिस्ट्रिक्ट में एक फेमस कोच होता है, उस कोच के पास जाओ और कोच को पूछो कि अगर मुझे आगे खेलना है तो मैं कहाँ से खेल सकती हूँ. एट द सेम टाइम डोंट डिपेंड ओनली ऑन लोकल नॉलेज. बस सोलापुर का की बात मत करो, पुणे के कोचेस को फोन करके वहां पे फाइंड आउट करो वहां पे क्या सिचुएशन है. बहुत शेरलॉक होम्स गिरी आपको करनी पड़ेगी. फाइंड आउट इन द महाराष्ट्र क्रिकेट एसोसिएशन व्हाट द सिचुएशन इज एंड बी प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर अ लॉट ऑफ फोन कॉल्स टू फाइंड आउट द राइट इन्फॉर्मेशन. अगर आप उस टाइम पे वो टाइम इन्वेस्ट नहीं करोगे तो यू विल हैव हाफ द इन्फॉर्मेशन एंड यू वोंट बी यू विल बी अ लिटिल बिट स्टक व्हेन यू आर गोइंग अहेड.
Right. And I think there are a few questions asking about other states. So I think what I'm hearing is that if you are in some other state, let's say Karnataka or Telangana, you will need to make at least 20, 25, 30 phone calls. Just go to your local, the district cricket association or the state cricket association, call them up, visit them, find out more information. There is no other way apart from, as you were saying, saying that being Sherlock Holmes, being more investigative and proactive and just talking to as many people as you can. Unfortunately, we don't have a central platform where all of that information is available. Until that happens, you will have to make a lot of phone calls and actually physically go there and meet a lot of people. There is unfortunately no other way. So Snehal, since we have you for another 4 or 5 minutes, just wanted to ask you some people were asking questions about skills and mental toughness and the fact that since there aren't so many matches, how do you actually prepare yourself for a big match? So in terms of both the technical skills and the mental skills, do you have an overarching feedback or something to share?
So under the age of 18 or even under the age of 16, mera advice ye rahega ki aap multiple sports khelo. Jahan aapko opportunity mili, multiple sports khelo. Doesn't matter if or probably under the age of 14, multiple sports khelo. Jahan aapko opportunity milti hai, doesn't matter. Even aapko hafte mein 3 din hi cricket practice ke liye time milta hai. 3 din aap jaake football khelo, badminton khelo. That will develop overall fitness. If you cannot do that, up till the age of 16, 17, you must join a fitness training class or you must get some kind of fitness training. India mein sabse bada gap hai ki lower level pe fitness culture bilkul nahi hai ladkiyon ke cricket mein. To us samay, agar aap fitness class join karke, aapka fitness improve karke, baki sare ladkiyon se ek level higher ho, to under 16 level pe aap bahut jaldi fast track ho jaoge under 19 level. That is the advice I will give. Until the age of 16, 17, prioritize fitness even over skills. Aap agar thoda skills kam seekhoge, skills ko kam waqt doge, that is also okay. Give more time to fitness. These are mistakes that I made. These are mistakes that our generation made. Aur abhi ka generation fitness agar aap unka dekhoge, to it is top class. क्या होता है कि फिटनेस के वजह से ना आपके स्किल्स इजीली और जल्दी आप सीख सकते हो. अगर आप फिट नहीं हो तो आपकी बॉडी उन पोजीशंस में आके, उन अजीबोगरीब पोजीशंस में आने के लिए ज्यादा टाइम लगाती है. अगर आपकी बॉडी ऑलरेडी फिट है तो वो पोजीशंस आपको इजीली आ जाते हैं. सो अप टिल एज ऑफ 16 17 इन्वेस्ट मोर टाइम इन फिटनेस, लेस टाइम इन स्किल्स. सेकंड थिंग आई विल से, मेंटल टफनेस के लिए आई एम सॉरी पर मैचेस खेलने के अलावा देयर इज नो बेटर वे टू इंप्रूव. एक टिप मैं आपको दूंगी कि आप जैसे फिटनेस पे ध्यान दे रहे हो, वैसे आप मेडिटेशन और प्राणायाम के प्रैक्टिसेस पे भी ध्यान दो फ्रॉम द एज ऑफ 16-17. ये चीजें आपके मेंटल टफनेस को इम्प्रूव करती हैं. मगर गेम सेंस, मैच अवेयरनेस, आप मैच में कैसे रिएक्ट करना चाहिए, मैच में आप प्रेशर कैसे हैंडल करोगे, ऑल दीज थिंग्स विल कम विद मैचेस. और मैचेस की कमी नहीं है, बॉयज मैचेस की कमी नहीं है, आपको बॉयज में जाके खेलना है. So I think that is the best way to gain experience.
Okay, awesome. So one final and probably an optimistic note to end this with, Snehal. What is your what do you see in the future, in the next 5-10 years? What are the things that are going to change to make it easier for the next generation? And who's going to do it?
I hope it changes. मैं seriously बाकी states के, बाकी states नहीं, बाकी countries के support staff के साथ बात करती हूँ. I talk to people who are setting up women's cricket programs in other countries, और सब लोग डरते हैं कि अगर इंडिया ने अपना वुमेन्स क्रिकेट में ध्यान दिया और अपना वुमेन्स क्रिकेट का जो ग्रास रूट प्रोग्राम है ना वो अच्छा बनाया, इंडियन वुमेन्स क्रिकेट टीम विल विन एवरी वर्ल्ड कप इन द नेक्स्ट 10 years. इतना टैलेंट है हमारे पास, लाइक हमें गलती से ये टैलेंट मिल रहा है अभी तक. इट्स वी आर गेटिंग इट डिस्पाइट द सिस्टम, नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ द सिस्टम. सो इफ वी पुट इवन जस्ट 10% मोर एफर्ट इनटू आवर वुमेन्स क्रिकेट प्रोग्राम्स, वी विल जस्ट डोमिनेट वर्ल्ड क्रिकेट, इज माय प्रेडिक्शन. बट दैट्स अ वेरी बिग इफ. व्हाट आई कैन से, आपको जो अभी क्रिकेट, जो अभी ये सेमिनार देख रहे हो, यू टेक इट yourself very seriously as to your own game. Cricket ek team game hai, magar practice or preparation individual hoti hai. You cannot expect ki state association jab camp, fitness camp lagayega ya fitness trainer employ karega, tab mera fitness level badhega. Tennis players, badminton players, sab apna khud ka fitness karte hain, khud ka fitness sambhalte hain. इंडिविजुअल स्पोर्ट्स से सीखो कि वो किस प्रकार से अपना फिटनेस और अपना गेम का रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी खुद लेते हैं. दे इन्वेस्ट whatever money they have or whatever money they can afford or whatever money they get from the game, they invest back in their game. They hire physios, they hire fitness trainers. So, जो भी यहाँ पे देख रहे हैं, अगर आपको professionally cricket खेलना है इंडिया के लिए, अभी से आप professional बनो. Professional का मतलब यही है कि जैसे आपके मम्मी पापा professionals है, they work 8 hours a day. तो आपको 8 hours a day cricket को देना है in terms of fitness, in terms of आपका nutrition, in terms of आपका स्किल डेवलपमेंट. तो इन सब चीजों में अभी इन्वेस्ट करो, टाइम इन्वेस्ट करो. आपके स्टूडेंट इयर्स है, आपके पास थोड़ा टाइम ज्यादा रहेगा. बाद में इट विल बिकम इवन मोर डिफिकल्ट. सो टेक इट अपॉन योरसेल्फ टू बिकम प्रोफेशनल क्रिकेटर्स इवन बिफोर यू प्ले फॉर योर स्टेट और फॉर योर कंट्री, और फिर इंडियन क्रिकेट का स्टैंडर्ड अपने आप बढ़ेगा.
Right, right. Awesome. So thanks a lot, Snehal. This is excellent advice, and I hope everyone who is here tuned in found this immensely useful. Probably there are so many questions that we can't really fit that in this time. So I'm sorry if we are unable to answer all the questions. But Snehal probably will figure out a way to have you back so that we can the number of questions and the interest that we have seen, probably we'll figure out a way how to do this more regularly, so that at least we can play our part in sort of decrypting and helping the budding women's cricketers achieve what they have set out to achieve. Right. So everyone who's attending, don't worry. We'll have this more often. We'll probably include your questions. And again, thanks a lot, Snehal, for joining us and sharing your insights. I hope everyone found this inspiring and will take away some great advice. So thanks a lot, Snehal, for that.
Pleasure. It was fun, and hopefully everyone also had fun and learned something new. One thing I will say is, if you want to learn more about if you really want to study ki women's cricket ka situation kya hai India mein, so you can read the Equal Hue report.
Yeah, I'll just share that.
Nikhil will share the link. It's a very big report, but if you read it, you will get a very good idea of what is the state of women's cricket overall in the country, and hopefully that will help you answer some of your questions.
Right. So thanks, Snehal, and hope to have you back soon, and we'll probably have more sessions like this sometime soon.
Same here. Chalo, bye bye.
Okay, bye, good night. Hi everyone. So Snehal was available for a limited time, so we took as many questions as we could, but we will have this more often. And after this I'll just from our team will share a summary of everything that we discussed today. So we'll everyone who is here will get an email with a summary of the things that we discussed. And if you are in this session, then of course we would have your email ID. So after this session, by sometime tomorrow, we will share the details of our program. There is a URL that you can go to in case you want to visit that right now and check out the program that we have developed along with Gary Kirsten, which is the online learning program. And there are specific packages for batters, bowlers, fielders, and everything. We'll share more details about this over email, and you can always drop us an email on cricket@nurture.com. This is our email ID. So any feedback, any other details, any other thing that you need from our side, you can just drop us an email there. We will also, as I was saying, we'll share some notes from the session, all the excellent advice that Snehal shared with us, and we were overjoyed by the interest that we received in terms of registrations, in terms of the excellent questions that you had asked. There is limited time, so we can only ask so many questions, but we will make it a point to try and answer each one of those questions, because that is the sort of vision that we have set out to do. So don't worry about it. We'll try and figure stuff out and share that with you, and we'll be in touch over email. I've already shared our email ID. After this session, I'll share a summary of everything that we've discussed. I'll share about details about the online learning platform with Gary Kirsten. I've just shared the URL also, cricket.nurture.com, where you can visit, have a look at some of the the sample videos, register for a free demo. And if you like it, if you like the knowledge that is being shared by a World Cup winning coach, you can also, you know, sort of be engaged and drop us a line in case you're interested in exploring that further. In terms of Instagram page, yes, we do have an Instagram page. You can just check out, just search for Nurture Cricket on Instagram and you should get our page. We try and break down live cricket games and take out insights from those and share that on our social media. So in case you don't follow us on Instagram and Facebook, please make it a point to do that because we try and share insights from the games itself. So with that, I'll just end this webinar here. I hope everyone who attended found that really useful. We'll be in touch. Yes, we'll share highlights from today's session on Instagram and on email. Don't worry about that. We'll just, our team will work to create that. Yaman, if it is possible, can you just drop the Instagram link here? Because I think there are folks who are unable to find it. So just drop that URL here so that people can follow it. And in case you already haven't registered on our website, and you know, since you are here, I'm assuming that all of you are already have given us your email IDs and where we can share more program details with you. But in case you haven't, you can just go to this URL, cricket.nurture.com, to learn more, to see those sample videos, to learn more about our program and how it will help you, you know, in terms of batting, bowling, fielding, mental strength. There are 50 plus lessons covering all the skills. We also are coming up with a video analysis product where you share your videos and you can get feedback from experts on that. So we'll share all of that over email once this session ends over the next few days. With that, I'll just end this session here, and I hope to see you soon. And we'll be trying to organize more webinars with more experts so that you are also building on your knowledge and learning about how to achieve what you have set out to achieve. So again, thanks everyone. Thank you for taking the time from Nurture Cricket team. We hope you found it really useful, and we look forward to interacting with you and seeing you soon in webinars, in our courses, in our video analysis. So on our social media platform. So just stay in touch, and we'll keep coming up with insightful and knowledge stuff that will help you, you know, get more knowledge and achieve what you have set out to achieve. So with that, thanks a lot, everyone, for attending, and we'll be touch over multiple platforms. So thank you and good night.